evening, ladies and gentlemen. I have to say what a pleasure it is to be here talking to you. You may wonder where we are. We are in Suleimaniyah. We're in Iraq, Kurdistan, northern Iraq. Come here to the cradle of civilization in search of culture, songs, music, all sorts. And why am I sitting here at this particular moment? I'll tell you why I'm sitting here. It's because today, 24th of March, is the birthday of Dario Fo. I'm a translator, io sono traduttore. Sono 30 anni che io traduco Dario Fo e Frank Arano. And I thought it would be a good idea to do a little celebration of Dario's work here in Suleimaniyah. Originally, I thought that I would do the acting. But then I discover this is not necessary, because I have another man here to do the job. And here is where the mystery begins, ladies and gentlemen. The mystery begins with a piece of rope. A piece of rope. You have no idea what this piece of rope is, do you? No. All right, I will explain in a moment. It will become apparent. More to the point, ladies and gentlemen, in the bag, what we have is a pair of these. A pair of boxer's gloves of the Sphinx brand. You may ask, why am I traveling with a pair of boxer's gloves in a bag? The answer, ladies and gentlemen, is that I am not. But I have met here a comrade, a journalist, and a boxer. Pugile, un giornalista, Luca, who is also here writing, researching, looking into politics, pursuing his studies. He, ladies and gentlemen, is from Sardinia. And he, ladies and gentlemen, is precisely a boxer. And because Dario's latest piece of work is a piece about a gypsy, a Roma boxer in Nazi Germany, we thought that it would be a nice moment. Abbiamo pensato che sarebbe un momento buono e bello per raccontare un pochino the story of this boxer. So having said that, I am now going to hand over to Luca to tell you the story of the boxer in question.
Okay, buonasera ladies and gentlemen, we are here to, I reckon, to tell the story of Rucchelli, Alberello. Was Rucchelli, Mr. Trollmann, a Sinti, a gypsy, it's uno zingaro, we may say. Rucchelli was born in Bassa Sassonia and he was a genius of boxing. His coach was a Jew in Germany, 1933, when the Nazis came to power. And what happened? He was a brilliant, brilliant boxer, a genius, a dancer. A dancer, Muhammad Ali, 30 years afterwards, would have taken and stolen the movements, the dancing. You remember that, the dancing, you know, the butterfly and the bee, that originated with Trollmann. Trollmann, who had the chance to fight against Vitt, he was the first opponent, and he bit Vitt, you know, like come una zampogna. And what happened? The title, the German title they were fighting for, was taking place in a pub, in una birreria, and the referee was biased. Why? Because the German Nazis had set the old scene for, you know, the blonde guy to win. But as soon as the referees, you know, told to the public that the match ended up in a draw, the whole pub population, you know, it came up protesting, fighting with a huge rumble in the pub. and they were forced to declare, you know, how a Trollmann, Rucheli, l'alberello, winner, champion of Germany, uno zingaro campione in Germania del 1933. So the Nazis took their revenge. Who was the next opponent? Heather, big guy, you know, a giant. And the fight and the, you know, the mission, Troll's mission was already difficult, but the Nazis forced Rucheli to avoid his dance, and it was compelled to stay at the center of the ring. And as a reaction, as a protest, what did Rucheli do? He just, you know, turned his hair blonde and spread, you know, the la farina onto his body in order to make fun and to make ridiculous these rules about Aryanism and racism. So they fought, and of course after five rounds he went down, you know, he lost, of course. But it wasn't enough. It wasn't enough because the Nazis destroyed his life. He was sterilized, and after that he was sent to Russia. And when back from Russia, he was sent to a concentration camp in Wittenberg. When he was, you know, kicked out, he was humiliated, but with a couple of potatoes, 100 grams potatoes more every day. They made him stand because, you know, the couples had fun, they recognized him at the camp and they wanted him to fight, you know, to destroy again his celebrity, his strength, his dance. It was the utter, the ultimate humiliation. But one of these chaps, one of these couples, Cornelius was called, you know, got a big surprise one day because they made a circle around him, and with the last strength Trollsmann had, made maybe his most glorious, his most glorious match, putting Cornelius down, in a beautiful knockout. The story ends that a few days afterwards, the championship, the world, maybe the universe, the humanity championship, Cornelius went after Trollmann while he was working and killed him, striking him with several times with a shovel. Now what we got now is a monument in Berlin, and that monument has nothing on it apart from a number, 9841, Trollmann, Rucheli, Alberello. Auguri, Dario, abbasso la guerra, abbasso l'oppressione, viva la libertà, viva i pazzi, viva Trollmann e viva l'Italia. Auguri.